going.
Romeo Void. In the early 80s, their rhythmic melodies and sexy lyrics propelled them to fame. But with the advent of music videos, lead singer Deborah Ayel Size put the band's success in jeopardy.
She just said, "This is who I am. If you don't like it, I'm sorry. You know, go to hell."
Now we're going to try and bring them back together one last time.
Peter Woods?
Hi.
Hi. Aaron Smith?
What's up?
Would you like to participate in a special reunion with your former bandmates?
Well, will I be able to find the original members of Romeo Void and convince them to take part in a one-night-only performance? Deborah Ayel?
Reunited?
Hello.
I was looking for Frank Sienkiewicz.
Yeah, would you like to do that? Would you like to take part in it?
You get one shot.
Really?
Lightning strikes once.
Is Ben going to be here?
I gotta go. I can't do this anymore.
What the f*** is going on?
Oh, no, here's the thing.
It's not worth going into.
Romeo Void burst onto the music scene when lead singer Deborah Ayel and bassist Frank Sienkiewicz formed the group while attending the San Francisco Art Institute. In 1984, the band had their biggest hit with Despite the single's success, rumors suggested that image-conscious record executives pulled their support of the band after seeing footage of the heavyset lead singer.
I'm sure there were a lot of icky conversations in back rooms that I didn't have to listen to about what are we going to do about her.
The record company's abandonment, coupled with health problems and tensions between band members, took their toll on Romeo Void.
Unfortunately, Ben had developed this problem with his hearing.
The thing that we did that made us special was being torn apart.
In 1985, lead singer Deborah Ayel, along with band members Peter Woods on guitar, bassist Frank Sienkiewicz, drummer Aaron Smith and Benjamin Bossy on saxophone, played their last gig and walked away from each other. Will we be able to get these five band members to reunite? We have our work cut out for us.
The journey begins right now.
We tracked down the lead singer of Romeo Void, Deborah Ayel, in 29 Palms, California. Deborah was the face and the voice of the band. And if she doesn't agree to reunite, our mission will come to an abrupt end.
All right. Deborah Ayel?
Yeah.
Hi. I'm Aamer from VH1. How are you? My name's Aamer.
What is this?
I'm here from VH1.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
You're joking.
I'm not. Actually, I drove a long way.
Why is VH1 out in 29 Palms?
The answer to that question lies with you, my friend, because I am here on a special mission, a mission assigned to me by VH1 and the fans of the great, great band Romeo Void.
Oh.
And that mission is to get Romeo Void back together again. Right now, we came to the first person we wanted to contact, and that is you.
Okay.
It starts with the lead singer. So, are you open to reuniting with your band? What the?
Well, for...
For a one-night-only gig?
Or something I'm saying, I would sing. What, you won't...
I will say yes.
Okay, until I have to say no, I'll say yes.
Okay. She's saying yes!
Wild.
This is
scared.
What I'm going to do is ask you to give me your autograph to say that you're on board, so you can just sign your artwork. It's beautiful.
Oh, there's still.
Oh, cool. Yay. All right, she's on board. I'd like to talk with you for a little bit as well. We can sort of settle things down and find a spot. Is that all right? Okay, so we'll find a spot and we'll let you settle down a little bit. And I'll introduce you.
This is bizarre.
Why don't we update your story in terms of what you're doing today and why you're in the community here of 29 Palms?
We're starting an art center here, the 29 Palms Creative Center. I'm going to be teaching printmaking here. I've been running various printmaking studios for about 10 years now.
So when you were a singer in Romeo Void, were you still an artist at the same time too? Did you have
We met in art school, me and the bass player,
right.
Frank, and I met at art school. And so, of course, we had to get together and start writing songs.
So then you and Frank and then subsequently Peter decided to put a group together?
Yes,
how did it all come
about?
Yes,
that's exactly right.
And Peter and Frank were basically responsible for the music then?
Yeah. And the sax player was like this wonderful accident.
He being?
Benjamin Bossy, incredible musician.
Eventually you got celebrity fans. I mean, you had someone like Rick Ocasek of The Cars who wanted to work with you and did, in fact.
How did you get together with Rick Ocasek?
We came to Boston. He called us up at the hotel and said, why don't you come by our recording studio? And then after that, he said, well, I'd like to produce a single for you. And Never Say Never is what happened.
So the first album came out. What was the reaction to it initially?
Actually, what happened is we were out on tour supporting It's a Condition, our first album. Mm-hmm. And MTV came out. And we were one of the original videos on MTV, the black and white one that we had done.
And you were helping to launch that look.
It was wild because... Yeah. There was a definite difference between before MTV when we were on tour and after MTV when we were on tour. Because
right.
All of a sudden, people knew some of our songs.
And they knew what you looked like. There was a definite way for them to identify with you.
When Romeo Void signed with a major label, suddenly Deborah's size became an issue.
I'm sure there were a lot of icky conversations in back rooms that I didn't have to listen to about what are we going to do about her.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, now we just call it Big Beautiful Women, you know.
Right.
It was kind of like you're fighting against the tide a little bit.
A Girl in Trouble, which was a huge hit for you guys as well. Did you think that, okay, now we're on an upward spiral?
We were pretty much hoping for that, yeah.
Yeah.
And then our hopes were sort of dashed.
How so?
We got about halfway across the country, and Columbia pulled all support from the record, and at the very next concert, there was no press. When they decide, and that's it. Bye.
We want to do this reunion sooner than later. We're looking at next week. What we want to do is put you guys in the same room next Tuesday, and by next Wednesday have you up on stage in front of your audience. Welcome aboard! Thank you for doing this. This is awesome.
That is wild. Next week.
Deborah is on board and told us that we could find Frank in Oakland. Deborah Ayal told us that bassist Frank Zinkevich was living in Oakland, California. To catch him off guard, we snuck up on him under the cover of darkness with cameras and lights blazing.
I think someone threw the lock. Somebody came to the door and then they just left. Hi.
Hi.
I was looking for Frank Zinkevich.
Yeah.
Is that you?
Yeah.
Hey, Frank, I'm from VH1. How are you? I'm on a bit of a mission.
Go on.
Oh, no. Here's the thing. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. And I'll explain to you if I can.
Yeah.
Can you come out?
Explain to me first what the deal is.
What we're up to is we are going to the various members of VH1's favorite bands to talk to them about this really cool thing that we have going on. If you could just step out for a second, I just want to just talk. It's kind of weird talking to you through the screen door.
Yeah, I know.
It's
but
a
it's
good
kind
thing.
Of weird having someone come to your front door.
I know.
And not being told what's going on.
I absolutely know that. But honestly, it's a cool thing. It's a cool thing.
For you guys.
No, but...
The industry is really f***ed up. The record industry, the music industry,
right.
and things like this. That it's, you know, there's people sitting in rooms going... Oh, this would be a great idea. Let's do this thing.
Yeah.
And the artist is never really, the artist is really secondary to the whole thing. So what was your question?
My question is, would you mind coming out now?
Oh, we'll come out.
Thank you. Here he comes. The question is, Frank. Hi, Aamer.
Hi, Aamer.
Nice to meet you. The question is, would you be interested in reuniting with your old bandmates from Romeo Void for a special One Night Only performance?
Sure.
He's there! That's awesome. That is wonderful. If you would just give me your autograph.
Do you want to come in? Or you?
Could we?
Sure, come on.
We would love to come in and have a talk with you. Thank you. Frank, thank you for welcoming us into your home. I was a little skeptical outside, but understandably. Tell us a little bit about what you're doing now.
I'm still involved in music. My main gig is working as a contractor.
What was your reaction to Deborah when you met her?
She was just really positive and, yeah, this is be great, we can do this. Everybody's doing bands, we can do one too. It was contagious to have that energy and that enthusiasm that she had. It was great.
Well, I just decided that if they can do it, I can do it. I have something to say.
I heard a story whereby you were doing a showcase and execs in Japan saw Deborah.
Well, that was another element. Deborah, was not a small person. You know, we felt that she's got the vocal chops. That's what counts, you know. The look became really important. And Romeo Void was never, geared in that direction.
Is it safe to say the record company's view of how she looked prompted them to pull back their support for you?
I think so.
Yeah, I think because I know when we did the video for Girl in Trouble, supposedly they weren't as interested in trying to push it at that point.
Really?
Once they saw the video. And it was also the first video where they wanted another female actor in the video as a part throughout the video.
Frank, as we've been trying to reunite Romeo Void, we've heard some troubling news about Benjamin. What can you tell us about him?
Benjamin, towards the last couple of years, he was having a lot of hearing problems. So that's one of the things in terms of us playing again, the possibility of Benjamin actually picking up a horn again. I don't know how possible that is.
Now, as I go on this quest to get the band together, I'm going to need your help. How would I find Peter Woods?
Well, Peter Woods is in Japan.
Oh, so okay.
Have an email address and an address for him.
Well, Frank, thank you so much for your time.
Two down, Frank is in, but boy, was it close. It took some convincing, but guitarist Peter Woods agreed to fly 12 hours from Japan, where he's now living. Peter thinks he's coming to L.A. for just an interview about bands from the 80s. What he doesn't know is that we'll be waiting for him at the airport to pop the question, will you reunite with Romeo Void? We waited for Peter. And waited.
We're not sure what they say about the best laid plans, but we had a great game plan.
The problem is, he slipped right by us and went straight to the hotel.
We were told he's there.
Alright.
So we just need to go and bum rush him at the Renaissance.
We're off to Peter's hotel.
I have the most important piece of equipment for this tape to cover the people.
Shh, absolutely. Shh.
He may have just gotten in from a 12-hour flight from Japan, but he's about to receive some unexpected company.
Hi, Peter Woods.
Hi.
Hey, my name's Aamer.
Hi.
VH1, how are you?
Fine.
Actually, I had a very important question to ask you.
Yeah, sure.
You came all the way from Japan.
Yep.
12-hour flight.
Yeah, I'm really tired.
Very tired. Quick question.
Okay.
Are you open to reuniting with Romeo Void for a special one-night-only gig?
Am I open to it?
Yeah, would you like to do that? Would you like to take part in it? I'm going up to everyone from the band and asking them that question. Would you like to reunite with Romeo Void?
I think I could do that.
He's in. That's awesome. All right, he's in.
Kind of shaky right now. I'm like total jet lag.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Peter Woods, ladies and gentlemen, he's in.
Yay! Can we talk right now?
Yeah, can I get my shoes?
Yeah, well, you take your time, but as long as we can go somewhere after.
Shoes, I need shoes.
Okay.
Peter brings kind of a happy-go-lucky, guitar playing fool thing to it.
A little surprised to see us at your door?
Yeah, it's been a while since I've had cameras in my face.
Really?
Well, I lead a normal life now, so.
And what's your life like now? What are you doing in Japan?
I have an English school. It's my own.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I have a lot of students.
Grandfather!
Good.
There's this little song called Never Say Never that really took off. There's that guitar line that starts that song.
And there's this band called the Bush Tetras, and they had this guitar player that was doing this kind of crank, crank, crank. And Frank and I thought, well, that's pretty cool. We started jamming on this. I started doing this thing, and then Frank did this bass part to it. That's how it happened. We were in Boston and we were doing an EP with Rick Ocasek. We did this last show in Boston. We just happened to do that song as an encore. And it wasn't even a song then, it was just a jam because we had no other songs to play. Right. And he heard that, he goes, we have to record that. So the next morning we just threw everything back into the studio and recorded that song. It almost never happened.
How did the wave of success with Never Say Never affect you guys? What started to happen then?
Well, that's when the big labels started coming, and then it got really weird.
I heard that maybe, in some cases, the lack of attention towards some members of the band led to some type of dissension amongst
the
members.
Okay, yeah, that's a fair statement, and I'm guilty as charged. If I had it to do over again, I would have done it differently. It's not her fault that she got the attention. She's great. She should have gotten the attention.
Right.
I think I was a little jealous because I felt like I'm contributing to this band, but I'm not getting all the attention. It's very selfish of me.
A lot of people were coming to me and saying, why don't you just be Romeo Void? And I was like, no, I can't be Romeo Void without my guys. That is Romeo Void.
When it was over on that last tour, did you know?
I knew it was over. I had already applied to law school. I'd already been accepted. I was out of there. I felt it was everything was out of control. If Frank was going over here, Deborah's over here, I go, well, where's the band? I can't contribute to this anymore. I really felt lost. I felt like, you know, what the thing that got us together was just, it was exploding. It was spinning out of control, and I don't like that feeling.
How did you know, or how did you find out that ultimately it was done? Was there a phone call, anything of the sort?
It's never like that.
Yeah.
It's just, things don't happen like that. You know, the phone call or the, someone says, I want a divorce. It doesn't happen. It's just, no one says anything. Hmm. It's this silence. It's a silence.
Well, listen, I want to thank you for not only making the trip from Japan to be a part of this, but also for making this reunion happen, because without you, it wouldn't have happened. So thank you very much. Pleasure meeting you, Peter.
Jet lag Peter Woods agreed to perform, but we're running out of time to find the last two band members. Next, Benjamin Bossy drops a bomb. Nashville-based drummer Aaron Smith is flying to L.A. with plans to see his daughter. We were there to meet him. Can we convince Aaron to pick up his sticks and play with Romeo Void one last time?
Aaron Smith?
What's up?
How are you? I'm Aamer. Come on in. Get in the car. Aaron Smith, drummer extraordinaire. Formerly of a number of groups, including Romeo Void. I'm here from VH1. My job is to find the members of this great group, Romeo Void, and ask them if they would like to participate in a one-night-only reunion in front of their fans. Are you in?
I'm in.
He's in! Yeah.
Where's everybody else?
Well, we're getting them. Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
Just to help seal the deal, we need to do one little bit of business, and that is to get your autograph to say that you are in to take part in the reunion.
California, here we come, right back where we
thank you. Thank you very much. Whew, my job just got a little easier.
Aaron brought great drumming. He drummed for the Temptations. My God, it doesn't get any better than that.
Aaron, let's just start and get an update on your story right now. What are you doing in Nashville?
I'm working most of the time now in medical malpractice insurance as an underwriter.
Oh, wow.
I play every now and then, you know, in Nashville. When you're in a band, you can establish your own voice. So I was very disappointed when it didn't reach its full potential.
What do you mean by that? What do you mean by full potential? Because you had a top 40 hit, you know, under your belt.
We had a top 40 hit, and there were more. There could have been a lot more top 40 hits. You know, the band couldn't last. There was the seeds of destruction, I think, had already been planted before I got in the band. We haven't had a chance to make up.
Was there a need to make up, you think?
I think there's a need to make up, yeah. People start going their own way. Most of the disagreements and most of the talk, Deborah was getting a lot of attention. Everybody else in the band wanted to share in the spotlight. And she was getting 90% of it. But at the same time, she was getting 90% or 95% of the criticism.
I'm the scapegoat. As the lead singer who gets too much attention, when don't they know that I write the bass lines?
or the guitar lines, or the sax lines, or the drum beats.
And I really think, I don't know for sure, but I think maybe somebody inside the company was trying to get Frank and Peter and Ben to influence Deborah, to influence her to maybe lose weight or something, you know.
We never did. It was too sensitive. Never.
It was all that sort of pressure. That was the tension. She was getting the attention, good and bad, and they were trying to get her to change while being kind of jealous of the attention she was getting, if that makes any sense.
Yeah, it makes perfect sense. So are you looking forward to this reunion?
The reunion?
Yeah.
I guess.
We're gonna get you to hang out.
Oh, yeah?
And we're gonna get you to sort of rehearse some songs and then perform at the Whiskey on Tuesday.
On Tuesday, today being Sunday. Cool.
You all set for it?
Yeah, I'm ready.
You seem a little surprised, though.
I am. I am surprised.
All right. We look forward to making this happen. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you all.
Four down, but time's running out, and we still have to find one more band member. Will we get him? We're going back to Northern California to find sax player Benjamin Bossy. He thinks he's going to have coffee with a music researcher to talk about the old days. But with everyone's concern for his health, getting him to agree to perform may be out of the question. Will his condition derail our reunion plans?
You have a cigarette.
We think he's sitting outside in the red shirt. We think.
Hi, Benjamin Bossy.
Yeah, that's me.
Hi, I'm Aamer from VH1.
How you doing?
I'm fine. Might I take a seat beside you?
Absolutely not.
Oh, it's so good to see you, my friend.
See you.
I'm here from a very special show that VH1 is putting together. Would you like to participate in a special reunion with your former bandmates, Romeo Void?
Well, there's a well. I've never heard a well before.
What's the well, Ben?
I can't play the saxophone. My ears.
Can we at least get you in the same room? Would you be happy
to
reunite with
him? Absolutely. All that stuff, any of that stuff, yes.
Okay.
Absolutely.
So he's in.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
All right.
What we'd like to do is have your autograph, my friend.
Oh, very good.
Ladies and gentlemen, Benjamin Bossy, he's in. Yay, this is awesome. Way to go. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Welcome. This is great. So, Ben, tell me about your hearing problem.
Starting in 1982, actually, I started to notice that my ears were ringing. It got worse and worse and worse. By the end of the band, 1985, I was having a real hard time playing in performance because my ears were bothering me more and more. And I was losing hearing. I have problems hearing dialogue on television, and I get videos and I use the closed caption. I don't go to movies, I don't go to concerts.
Is this a condition that happened as a result of you being a musician? Or?
I paid the price. Here's the rub. The saxophone makes a sound in your head as it's being, going through the instrument, coming out. That head sound was making me more deaf. 1989, last time I played. That's it, over.
Wow.
God, it's weird talking about this, because all of a sudden I realized, if I had to do this again, I would.
Really? Mm-hmm.
To be quite honest, sure. I consider my hearing loss directly a result of my alcoholism and drug addiction, because being on alcohol, being on drugs,
right,
you don't notice things. Because of that, less loss of sensitivity, I didn't see it. And also it kept perpetuating it because it was more of a problem, so I'd drink more, I'd use more, it kept feeding on itself.
Ben brought beauty, lyrical horn lines, just unbelievable. Straight from the heart, unbelievable.
You felt there was dissension in the band towards the end in particular.
The dissension, I think part of it was just put from the outside. It didn't start from the inside.
Why do you think that happened?
Well, I'll tell you simply what happened is that in 1982-83, music television was just coming, and visually people were not used to what they were going to see. Deborah, our singer, is a big girl, big woman, proud of it, good big woman. Here's a story. We went down to the whiskey. Get out there. I look out there. Entourage. Clive Davis and X number people. Deborah Isle walks on stage before we even play. Whoop! Up, they're gone. True story.
Come on.
True story. Nothing against you, Clive. It's the industry.
The guys in the band, did you have meet separately and say, you know what, this is an incredible problem that we have. We have a great vocalist, a tremendous lyricist, but she's also our Achilles. Did you talk about that?
I think we talked about it, but we also realized that that was who we were. That was the band.
Her voice and her image is really was very big, and I mean, without her, it would be nothing.
Nobody was looking for another singer. I mean, you couldn't get another singer, you know? Where Deborah goes, Romeo Void goes.
Did you know Never Say Never is used in the video game Grand Theft Auto?
Okay. I'm not gonna cry now. So I come home, right? And there's a message on the machine. And it's Never Say Never playing really loud from that game. And my nephew's going, dude, this is you. Awesome. Awesome. Click. And I started crying. You know, it was like, it was so cool. It was such a beautiful thing, you know.
Well, Benjamin, it may be science fiction to you, but it's been tremendous for me to sit and talk with you.
It's been a great trip for me.
So we've got Ben to at least reunite. Coming up next, joy and heartache as Romeo reassembles for the first time in over a decade.
It brings back all these feelings and emotions.
Wow. I'm not going to be able to play.
It's very difficult, you know.
With the big gig looming, the old friends race to remember their hits.
I'd rather have, like, a lot more time with rehearsal. It's not enough.
Now, if I can only remember the words.
There's rustiness. There was a few, you know, definitely missed notes.
In the Hoffman household, we have a Friday night ritual. Two pizzas and a DVD. Sounds fun, huh? Well, recently, I've started a new Friday night ritual. Checking out the new classic music video playlist on VH1's great broadband site, VSpot. Yes, you are just a click of your computer mouse away from a new playlist featuring some of your favorite music videos. Go to VSpot at VH1.com each Friday to check out VSpot's newest playlists from your favorite VH1 classic shows. Remember, celebrate your Fridays with your all-time favorite classic music with classic playlists on VSpot. And don't forget the pizza.
What I love about her?
What I love about him.
How much time do we have?
At eHarmony, we know you don't need any help figuring out what attracts you on the outside. So we help with areas of compatibility that you can't see with the naked eye.
I love Thomas because he's just...
I really actually couldn't even begin to tell you what I love about her because it's pretty much everything.
At eHarmony, we only match you with other singles who've been pre-screened for compatibility with you. And when compatibility is ignited by chemistry, well, that's everything.
I love everything about Sharon.
Everything.
Everything.
Everything. I love him as he is.
He makes me laugh.
Well, look at her. She's incredible.
He's the most romantic man I've ever met.
It all starts with your personality profile. Yours free when you visit eHarmony.com today.
I know that when I'm with Kathy, we're going to be happy next week and next month and next year.
eHarmony.com. Log on today.
Pop-Tarts can't stand up to the delicious...
We've managed to find the five members of Romeo Void. Now, can we get them to hang out in the same room together?
Greg?
Hey, I'm here.
How are you, buddy?
Good to see you again.
Good to see you as well.
Driving in the car on the way here, I just started getting just excited about meeting everybody. And like I said, a little bit of butterflies.
Hey, everybody. How you doing?
Oh, Aaron.
Just nervous about seeing friends you haven't seen in a long time. I'm nervous about just the excitement of the moment.
Frankie! Hey!
Good to see you.
Man.
How many years have you been? Too long.
Wow.
94.
Look at this.
Check me out.
Yeah.
Check me out. Good to see you. How you been?
Peter Woods.
Hey.
How are you, sir?
Fine.
We've all moved on, and I have a, you know, a different life. And then suddenly it's revisiting you, and it brings back all these feelings and emotions.
The person that I'm very excited about seeing is Peter, because I haven't had a chance to catch up with him, you know, in quite a while.
Peter Wood!
How you doing?
Hi.
How you doing?
Hi. Wow. God, you still haven't gotten any gray hair.
No, amazing. It's totally natural, except for the color.
Benjamin Bossie.
Hey, what's up?
In the history of this program, that is the finest outfit I have seen.
Well, thank you very much.
Very nice.
It would really be nice if there could be that sense that what we felt like when it was like the group, you know, and that thing of that energy when we were all together, what that felt like, that would be great.
Oh!
Hey, look at that suit!
Oh, man! Hey, dude! Spread the love vibration.
Hey, Frank.
He always represented the second voice, in a sense, of the band.
Peter!
Still have it.
God, you came from Japan!
It's funny. We haven't changed at all. Vibration.
Deborah.
Hi, Aamer. I'm not nervous to see the guys. I'm excited to see them. I'm happy to see them. I love them. Something about getting together for a reunion makes you feel like a kid again.
Since Deborah and Benjamin's friendship predates the band, we decided to let them have a moment alone together.
Deborah!
Oh, Deborah!
Sweetie pie!
Oh, we're your darling.
Beautiful.
Oh,
I love you. Oh,
you
so good.
You feel good too.
Look at those eyes.
Look at us.
She said, what do you want to do when you first see people? And I said, I want to look in their eyes. So I get to look in their eyes. Wow. Love you too.
When I saw Deborah alone, it was like that whole thing of back when I first met her, because we, you know, I used to hang out with her, went over to her house and stuff. So before I met the band, I'd known Deborah. So that was kind of revisited that.
You look really healthy.
I am pretty
really
healthy.
Look healthy.
I've been clean sober for over 7 years now.
I love her. Can't wait to see Deborah.
Okay, I'm gonna get my gear.
Oh, you feel so good. Hi, baby.
Deborah represents the excitement and the exuberance of the band and the attitude of we can do anything.
It is so cool to have you here all together. Tell me how you feel.
It's 1982 and we're in San Francisco.
Right.
It's like we never left.
Ben, take us back to the time when you were in the band. You want to perform, but you're battling your condition.
We were on the road on that last tour. I was having a heck of a time. I was concerned then because my ears were ringing louder. I was putting in earplugs. I was trying things. Can't play anymore and all this stuff. And, you know, I sort of went through that. So it was very traumatic. Yeah, no question.
Speaking of unfortunate,
yes.
You can't carry on past this portion of our reunion.
Yes, I'm not going to be able to play. I'm not able to play the saxophone anymore. I have tinnitus, and I also have hearing loss associated with loud music.
Ben not being able to play is very difficult, you know.
Got to say goodbye to everybody. I'm going to be sitting out in the hall, and I'm going to be listening, and I really want, you know, you guys to have a great time and enjoy yourselves, and I'm really sorry I can't play with you, but I know you guys understand. Part of you is going, I don't want to be here. I don't want to be feeling this. I don't want to be thinking these thoughts. I don't want to realize I'm at this time in my life. I want to go back when it was fun and I could do all the things that I could do. But I'm also, you know, mature and old enough and have been through enough to know that that's over.
It's just kind of strange, you know, he has to leave the room. He was always a great front person along with Deborah. The two of them really, in my mind, always represented kind of the front line of the band.
Filling in for Benjamin will be Sox player Sheldon Brown.
Vocal. I got drums now.
My challenge is going to be to sing that loud with the right tone and intensity.
Sax solo, chorus, sax solo, and then it kind of repeats. It's just repeating itself. That makes some sense.
Can we, okay, just one more time, just from somewhere.
Now, if I can only remember the words.
Can we play now? Yeah.
Start to play, and it's like, oh yeah, that. Oh yeah, that. You know, and it starts coming back.
It's weird. It's like a weird dream. It's not. It's like it's not real right now.
It feels great. It's just amazing. It's amazing to be back. I mean, it's very sad not to have Benjamin there. But it's great having Sheldon there. All the same dynamics exist as always, you know. Aaron is just rock solid. Peter's wandering around, wondering, where'd my capo go? What happened to this?
I'm nervous, because we're not ready.
There's rustiness, there was a few, you know, definitely missed notes, and we're trying to remember what we were playing, what the parts were.
I feel a little rusty, you know, I'm thinking to myself, we played that fast?
I'd rather have, like, a lot more time of rehearsal. This is not great, it's not enough.
Next, the house is packed, it's go time.
Ladies and gentlemen, Romeo Void!
But for Benjamin, Romeo's reunion strikes a bittersweet final note.
Play, I feel so... It's hard to let go. It's really hard to just say it's over.
Guys, thanks for coming.
Are we in trouble?
No, you're not in trouble. I just want to set some ground rules.
Like what?
Well, remember last week when you hit Vinny in the head with the shovel?
I do not recall that.
Of course not. Well, it was pretty graphic. Too graphic for the kids. So I'm gonna have to block you.
You know, I gotta make this up to you. This is Vinny's watch, and I want you to have it. You deserve it.
Thank you. That's really not necessary.
No, no. Come here.
The flavor is back. It's VH1's.
It's showtime, and the members of Romeo Void arrive at the Whiskey, where they will perform for the first time in over 10 years.
We may not be on the scene making music anymore, but as human beings and as people, we have survived to the point that we can come back together and play.
Yeah, it's pretty big.
The reason I did it is because I thought this would be a good way to kind of say, this is what we've done, and now this is the end for me.
We've all matured and grown in a lot of different ways, and I'm hoping people are going to be forgiving of our a little bit of rustiness.
Oh yeah, it's the whiskey.
To be, you know, with this special group of people that is Romeo Void, in some ways it kind of feels like an answered prayer a little bit, even though I didn't know I was asking for it.
Oh, I really want to play. I feel so, you know, this was my life. Not only that, it's the whiskey, you know, it's like the biggest show that we played at the time, so I'm reliving all that stuff.
It's hard for Benjamin to watch this and not participate. Like, he has had a lot of time to come to grips with his hearing loss.
Have a lot of fun.
Have a great time.
This is really the first time in a very public forum that I am not physically with the band.
It's hard.
I'm really not in this band. I'm really not Romeo Void.
Okay, bye.
It's hard to let go. It's really hard to just say it's over. You know, it's over. You know, that
that moment before you go on stage as an individual or when you're in a group, I miss that moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, Romeo Void is a... band has rocked us. We are proud to welcome to the Whiskey a Go-Go, ladies and gentlemen, Romeo Void!
Thank you very much. Can you believe it? We just saw each other for the first time in 10 years last night.
About having a sound that's your own as a band. Like when you hear that, that's the only band it could be, is Romeo Void.
I might like you better if we slept together. I might like you better if we slept together. I might like you better if we slept together. But this song for y'all.
It was incredible. Deborah is great. She was great back then. She's great now.
They rocked. They were off the hook tonight.
It was great. Look what I got. The show was awesome.
Going back to Nashville tomorrow.
You know, that's in between songs, and you kind of go, well, let's just savor the moment.
I'm 51 years old today, getting up on stage again, trying to play your... Your musical skills kick in, hopefully, and it was really exciting and really fun to do it again.
I realized, hey, we just rehearsed last night. We haven't played this stuff in years, so why sweat it? You know, just let it happen, and it happened. That was great.
Literally started playing yesterday, so I was concerned. I think it came off pretty well.
There's a time when every girl learns to use her head. Tears will be saved till they're better spent.
I've damaged your ears beyond repair to not be able to do this anymore. But you had this experience, and isn't that wonderful? And now you're going to be able to have a closure.